Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and welcome to my next episode, Day 11 of my Let's Clash series. So before we begin, I'd like to show you guys this defense replay. This is a rather interesting defense as later you will see how much trophies I actually lost from this particular defense itself. So this guy was using giants and also archers to try to take out my base with some wall breakers and just a lightning spell. So going ahead, he managed to take out most of my defenses first, and then eventually the walls, they actually went down from the wall breakers breaking through the walls. So it's a really smart strategy and good strategy to use the giants to get rid of the defenses first, after that taking out the rest of the structures. So now scoring him a 3 stars, stealing 51 trophies out of me. So that was an interesting revenge that he did on me. So probably that guy was waiting to like for me to go offline, then he was trying to revenge me because my base was pretty weak. And of course, to revenge my base, it would be like finding a pretty weak base with a very high resources. So he stole like 100 over 1,000 resources out of me, but not to worry, I managed to find this base and I did an attack on it. So I decided to spread my troops in a semicircle manner. After that, just going through, plummeting through the defenses, taking out a lot of the structures. And then in the end, some of my troops, they managed to even go all the way inside to take out the town hall itself and scoring me the 3 stars, stealing me that 100 over 1,000 loot. So that was pretty nice. So this is another attack that I did. I decided to attack from the bottom because a lot of the resources were focused at the bottom, so I didn't want to bother on the top. And this was a Tower 7. To attack this Tower 7 is not easy, so I decided to deploy my troops in a V-shaped manner at the very bottom of the base using a multi-touch deployment to actually deploy the troops really fast. So taking out a lot of the resources and then just letting my troops just continue to do a little bit of damage, taking a bit of the resources from the town hall itself, eventually just ending the battle, scoring me 1 star, 55%. So back to my base. So as you can see, I decided to upgrade the walls as I had 1.5 million gold stocked up, upgrading them to level 6 pink crystal walls, and then upgrading more of the wall so that I could just spend the gold. I didn't want to keep a lot of gold with me, and I was going to upgrade my gold storage to level 10, which required elixir instead of gold, so I didn't have a problem with a gold. And then eventually I did one attack, I got like 100 over 1,000 gold from it, and then I got one of the achievement done, 50 gems out from it from the expo terminator. And then now going for another raid. So as you can see, 313,000 gold available for this base, which is very high. So I decided to go for it. It's a Town Hall 9. So Town Hall 9, I definitely see at 100% loot. If I'm going to see like a Town Hall 5 or Town Hall 4, it's definitely going to have a loot penalty. So I won't be able to see that high of an amount at this point of time, especially with the gold mines being at level 12 for this particular base itself. The gold will be able to stock up to a very high amount. So the Town Hall, since it's exposed, I decided to go for it too. I didn't have enough Barbarians archers to take it out. So I decided to drop my clan castle, which contains 2 balloons and 5 minions, to take out the Town Hall, which is strong enough to actually go ahead to take the Town Hall out. So now just going ahead to end the battle, as there's nothing else that I could actually get. So scoring me 1 star, 15%, and a very huge amount of loot. So now back to another raid that I'd like to show you guys. This is a 180,000 gold raid. I'm focusing more on gold as the elixir, as you can see in the top right, has just reached to the cap. And there's no need for me to get a lot of elixir at this point of time because the walls are just too low in level to be able to use elixir to upgrade them. Once I reach to level 8 and above walls, I'll be able to farm both of the resources and then be able to use both resources to upgrade the walls to level 9 and subsequent even to level 11. So that's something I'm really looking forward to. That's why I'm also actually rushing my town hall, so that I could use the elixir to upgrade the walls. So that's something that I really want to get. And I know a lot of you guys are saying that I'm rushing my town hall, this and that, my defenses are too weak. So yeah, that's not something I'm really too bothersome about it. And then now back to my base. So as you can see, I'm just scrolling down to show you guys my attack log. I decided to snipe some town halls as I wanted to push my trophies level. So currently it's at 1,400. Eventually I did another few more snipes. Sniping a town hall is relatively easy, but some of the town halls, they are like trapped town halls. So I do not want to show you guys any of the town hall sniping replays, so that if not, you guys will get really bored out of it, seeing that it's really boring. And then after that, now you can see the trophies I've reached to 1,610, and then eventually one of my structures have also completed. So in order to use up the gold, I upgraded the walls so that they don't go to waste when I actually go offline later. So upgrading the walls, trying to use all my gold up, and then eventually now left with 151,000 gold. So just spending more slowly at a time, not rushing my way, otherwise I won't be able to calculate them out slowly. So I decided to sell 3 flags so that I could get 30,000 gold in order to get the long awaited air defense, which a lot of you guys have been asking me to get. But to be honest, it's not really that important to me, other than it maybe helping out to take out some healers which people have been using to attack my base. But now if we take a look at a defense that I'd like to show you guys. This defense, this guy just took out my town, which I put it outside, and also the gold available to him is like puny, so it didn't really matter to me that much. So now if we go ahead and do an attack, we'll be able to get back 200 over 1000 gold from this particular attack. So just doing one attack, I recuperate whatever that I lost. In fact, I profit so much that in fact it exceeds the amount that I lost. So usually I'll lose like 1000 when people start my town hall, which they only get it from my town hall itself. And then eventually when I do an attack, I get back whatever that I've lost. So I'm really not too worried about defense. And then also, as you can see, this particular base also 200 over 1000 gold. So really, defense to me ain't really important. Maybe up to the extent whereby I upgrade my town hall to like town hall 9 or 10, then I'll focus more on the defenses. But I already have plans for my builders, which I'm really planning to use both of my builders, two of them, on the heroes upgrading time, so that my heroes will be able to upgrade to a higher level when I reach to like maybe mid town hall 9. Because heroes, they take way a lot of time to upgrade. 227.5 days to upgrade to max level, level 40. That's why I actually want to focus on that. So now going ahead to upgrade my walls after doing a little bit of farming, upgrading my walls so that I could use up all the gold. So that when later when I go offline, I will be able to not lose that much resources. That's why this is a strategy that I use. Usually when I go offline, I'll try to use up all my gold. Whether is it using up on walls, stocking up on decorations or whatsoever, it's better than letting other people steal the loot. Although decoration in the best optimum way, because you actually lose 90,000 per flag that you stock up. So that's why I don't usually do that. I only do that when my gold is actually overflowing and I need to like keep it for the next town hall level. So now as you can see, I decided to upgrade my army camp, getting it to level 6. Level 6, I'll have an extra 5 housing spaces. And then eventually now I did another attack just before I went to bed. And although the loot isn't that great, like 300 or 400 over 1000, but 160,000 is relatively good enough. So as you can see, my screen actually popped out. The Android interface, as you can see, popped out. I slide from the top. So yeah, I'm using Android to play on my this particular account. I'm not using any iOS devices to play on this. Whereas my main account and Brandon 2 account is being played on my iPads. So I didn't want to transfer my this account to that, as I'm kind of having a little problem transferring over. Can't really connect it, not too sure why. But nevertheless, I'm planning to get a new Sony Z4 tablet when it's actually launched in Singapore. Currently, it's still coming soon, so I'm just awaiting for it to come out. Then I'll probably get it so that I could enjoy playing it on another new tablet, because playing on a small device, first of all, I don't play that well. And second of all, it actually hurts the eyes a lot. So I do not want to play too much on the small little device. So yeah, that's it for this particular raid. So now let's take a look at some of the raids that I did. Scoring like total of around 500 over 1000 gold in just 18 minutes. So this is how I actually farm, sometimes winning, sometimes losing an attack. So yeah, that's it for farming really fast. So that's it for my this particular episode. Hope you guys have enjoyed it. I'll be able to continue to do more raids in the weekends, and then hopefully be able to show you guys more upgrades of the walls, more upgrades of my structures too. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching this particular episode, and remember to leave a like and also subscribe if you haven't, and clash on.